Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is nothing but the solar and wind energy. So from that subject, from unit number 1 to 4, we have seen so many topics from solar energy also and wind energy also. So related to that, in the today's lecture, we are going to see one of the case study. That is nothing but the estimate the temperature rise of the waters. So here we are going to calculate the temperature rise required for the waters. So here one example is given related to the finding the temperature rise. So example is that estimate the temperature rise of the water in a 100 liters capacity thermospine solar water heating system during a typical days of operations. Estimate also the electrical saved because of use of the solar water heater and the corresponding reduction in the monthly electrical bill. So let's see the solution or how to find out the things which we have to calculate. So we will perform an approximate calculation based on the following assumptions. So assumptions are that the system has one flat plate collector with the absorber plate area of the 2 meters square. Second assumption is that the solar radiation falling on the collector during a typical day is a 5 kilowatt hour per meter square. That means average solar radiation we have taken 5 kilowatt hour per meter square. This is a good assumption for many locations in India for 250 to 300 days in the year. Third assumption is that the collector efficiency is 50% from figure 2.6. This corresponds to the operating temperature of 70 degrees Celsius. And fourth assumption is that no water is withdrawn for use during the day. That means for the day we are not withdrawing the waters. So that is the assumptions which we have to consider. Now, equating the energy absorbed by the collector during the day to the enthalpy change of the water, we have got the solar radiation incident on the collector per unit area per day into the collector area into collector efficiency, and that is equals to the mass of the water to be heated per day into specific heat of the water into temperature rise of the water. So that both things we are going to equate. Which are that two things? Energy absorbed in the collector during the day to the enthalpy change of the water. So let's see energy absorbed, how to calculate energy absorbed. Solar radiation incident, so that is nothing but 5 into 3600. So collector area we have taken 2 meters square and collector efficiency we have taken the 50%. So mass of the water we have taken 100 meter, then specific heat of the water we have taken 4.2 and temperature rise of the water. But here we don't know right now the temperature rise. So temperature rise we are considering the 43 degrees Celsius. So keeping the values of all the things, we will get that assuming that the water temperature in the morning was 20 degrees Celsius, the temperature around 4 to 5 pm will be 63 degrees Celsius. Thus, the value assumed for the efficiency of the collector is justified. So, in order to calculate the electrical energy saved, we assume that an electrical geyser has an efficiency of 95%. Thus, electricity saved every day, it is equals to. So how to calculate electricity saved? That is nothing but 5 into 2 into 0.50% upon 95%. That is the efficiency of the solar electrical geyser. So it becomes 5.26 kilowatt hours. So taking the cost of electricity to be Rs 3.50 per units. So money saved per days are rupees 5.26 into 3.50. So it becomes 18.42. So reduction in monthly electrical bill will be 18.42 per day into 30 days. So 553 rupees bill will be saved. and this is the significant reduction, one of the significant reduction. So like that we will calculate the energy or the estimation of temperature rise of the water. So like that we will calculate the temperature rise of the water. So by this step we will calculate the temperature rise and how the electricity bill will be saved, that also we can calculate. So I think all of you have understand that how to save the electricity bill and how to calculate the time required, okay, or temperature raised. So I think today we will stop here for the today's lecture. Next point we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, friends.